for some time, and then we will start a new topic depending upon whether we are able to complete current things or not. I think we would be able to complete it because most of the things have already been done.
Solve this one.
can we find the right job partner?
So
like this top down. It is looking something like a magnet. Okay, so a top view, and if you have cut a section at midpoint, okay. So calculate the stresses at the section. So they are shown C and D. Okay, so C and D are two points. So you are cutting the section. C is here, D is here on this face, and moment is being applied in the plane of the curvature. So this is plane of curvature, and moment is also being applied in the plane of curvature. 8.3 is everyone calculate. This is the time when you should do the practice, not in your rooms. So where this is acting? This is acting on the entire section. How you are getting? So P divided by the area. So ideally you should first determine the R naught. That should be the in principle first step. So for calculating R naught, first you need to know this diagram. This diagram. So in this diagram, for that particular question, what is the value of H?
4.
That's why he has asked me. So think again. Let us go back to this moment. This H is in the direction of R1, R2. Okay? This H is in the direction of R1, R2. And R1, R2 you are measuring from where? From center of curvature. Right? So basically, this was the catch. Because moment is not, so suppose we cut the section here. Right? So this is your curved section. Cut the section here. But moment is acting like this. Okay. Moment is acting like this. Not like this. If it is acting like this, then it will be 4 cm. Otherwise, this is 6. Because here you are measuring. R1 will measure from here. R2 will measure from here. Okay. And this distance is how much? 6. So your x should be 6. Because this point is basically here from here. From where you are measuring R1 and R2. And if you go in this diagram, this point is point A, and this is basically 6, this is basically 4, and everything is being measured from here. So R1, R2. So for this case, calculate what is R1, what is R2. R1 is
80.
How much?
80.
8. How? 11 minus 3. And R2 is 11 plus 3, correct? Now we have R1, R2, B, H. Can you calculate now the R1? Please calculate. Use your calculator. Even I made this mistake initially. I was taking H as 4. But then I realized actually the moment is not acting, it is acting in the plane. So if in the exam, if this question is asked, so be very careful. Thank you. right? Plus minus E. So if you see this figure, basically I will again go back to this figure. This figure. Here. So this is the neutral axis, and you want to determine the distance from neutral axis. So this is basically your h by 2. So now you know the y value for C and D. With this now please calculate the bending stresses by putting in the Winkler back formula. Please calculate. So now please put these values in the Winkler back formula and calculate sigma x at D, sigma x at C due to bending.
Point two
eight. Into 10 to the power minus 2. we get that. Okay, and then comes R. R naught is 10.70.
No, it's 10.7.
You put 10.7 theta, and your y is basically 2.7, right? If you put all of that, where your theta is coming from? 192.26 centimeters. Is it? So it is roughly this one. Please calculate and confirm. Those who have not done it, please do that. Because after this we are going to start something very interesting, very interesting. After this you don't need to do any practice at home. Okay? If you do practice here, everything is well. At home you have to only revise before the exam. And take it to sleep. And are you working on the project part? What is the status for MATLAB part? Have you prepared some MATLAB code for your project? Because now more and more marks will be given only for progress made on the project for the MATLAB part. There has to be coding component which each one of you have to take care for your part. Those who will do coding, they will get marks, very high marks. Those who are doing coding, yes. There is some issue. Sigma X at T. Tell me. Who got this apart from Harsh? Those who have not got, please take the help from your friend. Okay. So now total compressive stress at B will be 192 plus the compressive stress coming into B. What is compressive stress coming into B?
8.3.
The total becomes something around 200.56 MPa. Something like that. Okay. So that is the total compressive stress coming at point B. So this is maximum compressive stress in this section. Now we are calculating sigma x at C. So what is M? 3.8. Correct? M by, what is Y? 3.8 into 10 to the power minus 2. Correct? Divide by E. After that we have to put A. A 24 into 10 to the power minus 4. E is how much? 128 into 10 to the power minus 2. Correct? Is it correct? Then we have to put R0 minus 5. R0 minus 5. What is R0? 10.72. Okay, and what is y? R naught minus Y. Distance from the neutral axis is 3.08. R naught Y minus Y is your basically U, correct?
So plus nu.
Why you must switch off?
Plus one.
Plus one, yeah.
So minus five.
That's right. So कोई बोली नहीं रहा था जिंदगी में सोच रहा हूँ कोई बोले. This should be plus one.
Minus one, minus one.
So now अभी क्या आ रहा
है?
The earlier one is wrong, right?
So first you will start
basic understanding of the torsion. Then we will understand torsion of prismatic solid bar of general cross section. Prismatic means a bar which has same cross section throughout the length. Prismatic. General cross section, it can be anything: rectangle, triangle, ellipse, circle, or any random shape. Okay. We will understand the phenomena of torsion in such kind of bars. Then, in your basic solid mechanics, you learned about simple torsion without any kind of warping. But suppose if you just show me this one, okay, and if you see the section, okay, long rectangular section, and if you apply twisting on this, you see, there you are seeing some kind of warping is happening, okay. So this will be also studying this particular topic. But suppose if you see this kind of section, okay, if I am applying torsion, and suppose I am not able to show, but you can imagine, if I apply, this is a circular bar, I am applying, it will uniformly rotate, okay, there is no warping. Okay. So we will understand from where this phenomenon of warping comes. We will represent warping in the form of warping function. So warping function, you remember, we discussed about Airy stress function.
Yes.
And for different kind of conditions, the Airy stress function gives the solution to the stresses, strains. It basically solves the plane elasticity problem. Similarly, warping function is something that solves the problem of torsion with warping. So we will see the warping function for circular section, for elliptic section, for triangular section. Then we will talk about the torsional rigidity. You know axial rigidity, EA upon L. You know flexural rigidity, EI by L. EI by something L cube or, and sometimes we take some coefficient depending upon the neutral axis rotation, right? Or cross section. Similarly, there is something known as torsional rigidity, the difficulty to produce twisting. Then we will see how to calculate the shear stresses caused by the torsion. Torsion is ultimately causing the shear stresses. So suppose if you want to design a beam for torsion, you have to put additional shear in. That question may be there always in the mind that, okay, suppose if you have to design a structure for torsion, what we have to do? You have to provide additional reinforcement, not on the flexure, but on the shear reinforcement. If you want to design a beam or anything for torsion. In the end, we will talk about the thin wall sections. Previously, we also discussed thin wall sections somewhere else. Shear center, we discussed thin wall sections, right?
Yes.
In open sections, we discussed, right? So, it means this particular chapter also has some link with the shear center chapter. Shear center, if you apply the force on the shear center, no twisting will happen. If you apply the force apart from the shear center, some twisting will happen, some torsion is caused. So, it means when we talk about the torsion problems, the mathematics becomes easy if we talk about the thin sections. But if we talk about solid section, mathematics is slightly complicated. I am not saying it cannot be solved, it can be solved, but then you need numerical approaches.